Juliette Boland. I'm a Time Lord. I'm from the planet Gallifrey of the constellation of Castarberus. I'm 903 years old, and I'm the girl who's gonna save your lives and all 6 billion Whovians on the planet below. You got a problem with that? In that case, allons-y! Hi, I'm Juliette Boland. Welcome to Juliette's Wibbly, Wobbly, Timey, Wimey show. Who has two thumbs and loves Doctor Who? This guy! On today's episode, we have a lot of things for you. One, you're going to see me in Cardiff, Wales in the Doctor Who exhibit. Next, we are going to show you the coolest Doctor Who room ever in the history of Doctor Who. And best part of all, he's from Canada! The coolest place on Earth! The happiest place on Earth! And finally, I got to interview one of the cast members of Doctor Who on the red carpet. I'm going to tell you later, it's a surprise. Silence will fall. Okay, are you ready to go to the Doctor Who exhibit in Cardiff? I am. Grab your sonic screwdrivers, get into your TARDISes, and let's go on an adventure in time and space. Let's go! Hi, this is Juliette Boland for the Anglophile Channel for Kids. Today we're at the Doctor Who Experience. I cannot wait to go inside. Doctor Who's my favorite TV show in the whole world. So come on, let's go in. People assume that time is a strict progression of cause to effect, but actually, from a non-linear, non-subjective viewpoint, it's more like a big ball of wiggly, wobbly, timey-wimey stuff. Ta-da! Whoa, look at the Doctor's TARDIS, it's so different. Oh, and look at all these tiny machines. Oh, death of the Doctor. Ooh, handprints. Matt Smith. JENNA COLEMAN.
Interesting factoid, David Tennant wore this outfit in the 50th anniversary special. And also, this is a machine that goes ding. It's so cool. This is the costume of Queen Elizabeth I, who actually marries the Doctor in the 50th anniversary special.
And you also got to see a lot of the Doctor's costumes, like the Third Doctor, the Fourth Doctor, even his scarf, and K9. Oh, and the Fifth Doctor, and the Sixth Doctor, Seventh Doctor, Eighth Doctor, Ninth Doctor, Tenth Doctor! I love you! And the 11th Doctor, both of his costumes, season 5 and 7. You can also have a photo opportunity. You can pose in front of the green screen, and then you can put on a costume.
You fall towards me like this, imagine you're falling through the vortex.
That's Harry, he's pretty cool. He puts the TARDIS behind us.
In 4, 3, 2, 1, it's taken out for you.
Well, that's fun, huh?
Yeah, that's definitely.
Yeah. And we're going to talk to him now.
I'm Harry. I've worked here for 1.5 years now, the Doctor Who Experience, yeah. I'm a huge fan of the show, yeah. I started watching with Tom Baker and then watched quite a few John McCurr episodes, and when it was rebooted with Christopher Eccleston, I started from there with Christopher Eccleston's way through, and I'm slowly working my way through all of the old Doctors at the moment. I've got quite a while to go yet, but I'm pretty on it at the moment.
Also, they have a lot of creatures from Doctor Who, like the Ood. And like the Ice Warriors and Face of Bo, aka Captain Jack. What happened? Oh, and that's from season 5. And you can also see a lot of stuff from the 50th anniversary and Time of the Doctor. And this is the evolution of all the Daleks. They looked pretty old, but I do like the new version Daleks. Oh, that's Davros.
Check this out.
This is a scarecrow from season 3 with David Tennant.
This is from the 50th anniversary special. It's the alien Zygon. It can change into a human form and make a duplicate. I think this thing needs some moisturizer. Oh my gosh, David Tennant's TARDIS. Oh my god. David Tennant's costume. Can I touch it?
Do not touch!
That was awesome! I can't believe I got to see all those things and David Tennant's costume. Best birthday ever! And by the way, interesting factoid, I turned 12. 12th Doctor. Wow, I just blew your mind. Now we're going to take you to Canada, to the coolest Doctor Who room in the universe. Take it away, Matt.
Hi, Juliette. It's Matt here from Toronto, Canada, in the Doctor Who room, confessing my love of Doctor Who here in Canada. I gotta tell you, I wanted to show you some of the cool things we have here in Nerd Town. So check it out. I know you like Doctor Who, so I'm gonna show you some of the things I've been collecting over the last 32 or so years. So check it out. I have a remote control Dalek from the 70s with its own little inlaid Dalek and the remote control. Of course, a Doctor Who Dalek clock. Very important, so you always know when to exterminate. Little unusual thing, my girlfriend made a baby's first time traveler book out of some fabric that she found, and inside it has the impossible astronaut, it has Cybermen and Amy Pond. So one day, my time baby, whenever it comes, will have something to play with. They're very passionate about their work. I've also been collecting sonic screwdrivers for some time, which I like to use as a pointing device. Sometimes at family dinners, I just go past the ketchup. I have Doctor Who magazines from the 70s, which are a big thing for me. I always love those. So we have a whole bunch of those. Your viewers are welcome to come and peruse the library. Speaking of library, I also have all of the Target books written about Doctor Who. Some were made into movies and others were not, but all were written by Terrence Dix, or a fair chunk of them. The DVDs, of course, are, this shelf is nothing but Tom Baker episodes, the man I love. So he's there, of course, he's here with Davros. Should have let his hand go so we can push the button down and be rid of him. That's what I want. Doctor Who Marvel comic book. This one is issue number one, hard to find. And I'm quite pleased to have it. I have a bunch of them here, which I used to collect. This is really cool, a crossover statue of Matt Smith and on David Tennant's body with Tennant's sonic screwdriver, made by these guys right here, a little plug. There was only 1,000 of them made, so if you can get one, I urge you to get one. TARDIS keys, old and new, but I have to figure out a locking mechanism for that first. And of course, when you're on the road, all of these Doctor Who, they've all been transferred into digital, and I have my jump drive made up to look like a TARDIS, so that's kind of cool. And for when the weather gets really cold here in Canada, of course, Tom Baker's scarf. It goes from here, all along, underneath the TARDIS lights. It goes down and around. There's 24 feet of it, which is kind of long, I know, but that's the way it goes. Juliette, I know you're a new Doctor Who fan, new episode, so check this out. I have the Genesis arc with the three Daleks and the actual arc inside there, which is really cool. Little Matt Smith. And of course, something for the car one day. I never break for Daleks. I would probably. I'm in Canada, you're in America. Friends are all over the world, so I tell you what you should do is you should go to Royal Mail and you should get some Doctor Who stamps. Write me a letter, get some stamps. Come and we will play in the Doctor Who room. It's always open for you and your mom and dad. Anytime you want. So welcome to come back anytime you like. Hope to see you soon, Juliet. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Matt, for showing us your really cool Doctor Who room. And in case you didn't know, he's a really cool comic magician. Check out his website. It's pretty cool. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for. I'm going to take you and the TARDIS, maybe David Tennant, to Hollywood, to the red carpet, where I get to meet JENNA COLEMAN, the Impossible Girl, Clara Oswald, the Impossible Girl.
What is it like to work with Peter Capaldi as the Doctor?
Amazing. He's generous. He is courageous and brave and inventive and isn't afraid to basically try anything. And in having that, that's just a great person to be on set with every single day. And he's so funny and joyful and dry. And I can just keep giving you like nice adjectives to say about him.
Are we going to see you next season?
I cannot say a word. I think it's nice because people can watch it and not know what's going to happen. And that's where you get the best television. So that's what we're trying to do. I think Listen was really strong. To be honest, the beginnings for me are always really, I really love The Snowman and I love Deep Breath. And because personally, that was like the beginnings of both meeting the doctors for the first time. So they've kind of got quite a special place.
I just met Jenna Coleman. I'm shocked right now.
That was so cool. I got to meet Jenna Coleman or Clara Oswald. And also, she's like about this height in real life. I thought she was actually shorter because in the show, Matt Smith is like literally a mountain and she's only up to his shoulder. Thank you for joining me and David Tennant and the TARDIS in my first episode of Big Ball Wibbly Wobbly Timey Wimey Show. It was a lot of fun. We got to see the experience in Cardiff, Wales. We got to see a cool Doctor Who room and we also got to meet Jenna Coleman. Awesome! Now it's time for some really cool giveaways. You can win this really cool Doctor Who shirt with Peter Capaldi and Jenna Coleman if you leave a comment below. If you leave a comment below, we will draw your name in a raffle and you may win this. I want to keep it. Now, if you have a really cool Doctor Who room or a really cool Doctor Who story, send us your video and you might be in a future episode of my show. Thank you for joining me. See you next time. Now, let's see if this works. I don't want to go.